As educators, we put students at the center of everything we do, including our time here in Olympia. Thanks to the hard work and persistence of WA members, we have won billions in new dollars going into public education. And primarily that's for salaries, so that we can continue to recruit and retain high-quality, caring individuals for the students we teach. Now we have the opportunity to be able to come together and negotiate substantial raises in salary and pay for all of our members, our K-12 certificated, our ESP, as well as our higher ed faculty. Standing together strong as a union, WEA has the power and numbers to negotiate fair salaries and pay for all.
I am extremely excited that the legislature has passed a $1 billion budget for K-12 teacher salaries and public education. We have been anticipating this day for a long time and following McCleary very closely, and this is a real celebration.
This $1 billion is targeted to go to salaries. We know that we have a huge recruitment and retention problem in the state of Washington and really nationwide. And so if we want to keep the best teachers, we need to make sure we're investing in them, and that's what we just tried to send a strong message this year. So we hope that every local school district will do just that. We'll first prioritize making sure that teachers have the salaries they need to live on, and that we're recruiting and we're keeping our best teachers.
I am tremendously excited about the budget that we have just enacted here in the legislature. It fulfills our obligation to 1.1 million students in 295 school districts, five of them in my district, the 28th. I actually decided to run for office, that is the House, because of this obligation that we had not met, a paramount duty. We now have a budget that fully satisfies our obligation to kids, and it will invest a tremendous amount in teacher compensation. I'm really excited about that. As a school board member, I understand the value of dollars being driven directly to the classroom. That means into teacher and staff salaries. This budget gets us there, and this is a great outcome for the students around our state.
As we debated the budget, especially around McCleary issues, there was a lot of discussion of many policy areas where we could put additional funds for really great purposes within education. I believe that we have to step up and meet the court mandate, and that's about compensation. Those other ideas are great, and I believe we should do them too. And that's part of what I will be trying to work on when I come back here next session. But we really had to finish the McCleary mandate first, and that's what that money is for.
Look, I think the legislature's intent related to fully funding education is putting the money toward that which the court has said it needs to go to, which is salaries. And I would expect that local school districts are going to be honoring that requirement. That's why we in Olympia are spending that money, so that the money can be best serving students and making sure the teachers are paid what they're supposed to be paid, and making sure that happens at the local level is incredibly important.
This is an opportunity as a negotiator to make actual meaningful progress, but only if you ask for it. It's okay to ask for it. We deserve it. The opportunity for a lot of districts is going to be large, and it's okay to go big.
Our educators are highly qualified, educated, wonderful people. And in this job market, our educators could walk out of the classroom and go apply at any job in this region and be very successful in other professions. So professional compensation really means that our educators can afford to stay in our schools serving our students, which is a noble and important purpose for our democracy and society.
Both my kids go to the local public schools, and they have since they were in kindergarten. And one of the things that we love is ensuring that our teachers can live in the areas in which they work. When that happens, it really forms a community in our schools. And that's what we want. We want our public schools to be part of the community. And so it's important that our teachers be able to live in the areas in which they teach.
At the school I work at, just last year, we lost one of our most passionate and talented teachers. She just got married, is hoping to start a family, and looked at her life goals, and despite her love for education, she just couldn't stay in that position. She didn't feel that her work and talents were fairly compensated, and she left to go to
job in investment banking, and our school is really missing her presence and her leadership.
That we can pay teachers better makes us a little bit more competitive and will draw teachers into our school districts. That benefits students. Well, you know, they always use the argument in administrative salaries about competitiveness. That same argument can be used across the board. If you want the best, you have to pay for the best.
The first step was making sure that the state kept its promise to infuse more money into the school system. Now it's up to teachers and parents and others to make sure that they're staying engaged at the local level and making sure that the school districts and the school administrators understand how important it is that those investments get made in the right places.
So WA members across the state, those excuses have been cleared. The ones that we've been hearing year after year, those are not relevant anymore. The legislature has delivered $1 billion. It's labeled salary. There is $1 billion of salary coming to our local bargaining tables, and it's our job to negotiate that. We have to negotiate fair compensation for all WA members across the state, and the time is now. Those excuses are gone. It's going to take hard work, it's going to take courage, it's going to take organizing, but it's our job right now to negotiate fair salaries for all of our employees.
WA members launched this effort and sustained this effort. It was huge work, and it paid off. The legislature has come through with billions of dollars to attract and retain high quality employees with competitive salaries and to provide better working conditions. Better working conditions lead to better educational outcomes for students, and that's what we were after to begin with. The hard work, sticking together, WA members working together is really what pulled this off.
I think this final budget is a huge win for educators and kids. Educators have been bringing their voices forward, visiting us here on campus, and making sure that we know what is needed.
The thing that keeps me energized and working in public education after 40 years is the quality of the colleagues, paraprofessionals, other teachers, other ESA staff members that I work with on the mission that we've taken on to provide the best possible education for our students. We want the best and brightest doing this work, and we have to have competitive salaries to attract them.
Classified employees deserve higher pay. Our paraprofessionals now we cannot keep for more than a couple months. We hire, then they're gone. I believe that the students are being cheated. They deserve to have a relationship one-on-one with a paraprofessional or any other classified employee in those positions. But we're losing them so fast they can't form that relationship.
I think one of the biggest mistakes teachers make is assuming that somebody else is advocating for the things that they care about. Oftentimes it's a small group of folks on the negotiating team, and I think if we can broaden that with teachers that might get overlooked or might not think that their voice is helpful, we'll have a much better result in the end.
Organize yourself well, stick together, get your bargaining teams going and your bargaining representative groups talking with each other, get yourself educated, and then go to the table and you'll be strong and you'll get what you need to have.
As our bargaining team goes into negotiations with the district, I want them to go in there full of pride for the work that we do, full of courage, and a little bit a spirit of rebellion or to make some trouble, to stand up and be ready to say, teachers deserve this, and we are strong, and we're a community together who can fight for what we deserve.
What we need is everybody from our unions to join together and go after them together. They're not going to give it to us unless we fight for it.